Okay guys, it's day 7 and we wanted to give you an update on how our microgreens experiment is going.
Welcome back to our channel. If you're looking for a channel that teaches you how to grow your own food so that you can stay healthy and build a strong immune system, and if you're looking for lifestyle medicine tips by a vascular surgeon who actually treats cardiovascular disease, then this is the channel for you. Make sure to subscribe and hit the notification button to receive notices every time we upload a video. We are currently uploading 2 videos a week, one related to growing food. The other usually involves an interview from our plant-based DFW podcast show. In this video, we will give you an update on our microgreens all the way through day 7. Make sure to watch the entire video as we explain some lessons that we learned. Enjoy.
All right, guys. Well, welcome back. In today's video, we're going to unveil our microgreens. It is day 4. In the previous video, we planted the microgreens and put them away, and so we've brought them back out. We'll uncover them and see how they're looking.
And just as a refresher, I planted microgreens in soil.
Yep, and I did mine in water on a jute mat. So I'm doing it hydroponically and she's doing it in soil. Every day I went and uncovered them just for a second to spray them down with a light mist. So let's start with yours. I'll put mine out of the way.
All right, so let's see. And by the way, he wouldn't let me look at all. He said I wasn't to disturb the seeds. So let's see what they look. Oh my God.
Look at that.
Wow, if you can see that.
That's just after 4 days of being undisturbed and in a dark area.
Why do you think they're yellow?
Because they haven't started photosynthesis yet.
Do you think this is like 2 inches of growth?
That is about 2 inches, yeah.
Oh my God, wow.
It smells like soil.
It smells like soil or very earthy. And then some are reaching out this way. Some are reaching out this way.
So, yeah, we did put them off into the corner of a room in a dark area. And we had them covered, but you can kind of see towards the edges. There's probably some light peeking in as they grew. There's some light peeking in at the edges. So you can see on the outsides, they're looking for light.
Just as a reminder, this is the broccoli seed. This would be a complete, how many hours?
This is about 96 hours, because it is day 4.
Okay, so yeah, I was hoping to film every day, but he wouldn't let me do that. Okay,
so we don't cover it up anymore. And now what we're gonna do is, we have right behind us our grow lights, which are ready to use. And we're gonna put them under there for the next few days before we harvest. And we're going to water these on a daily basis.
All right. And then these we can look at every day.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to kind of move mine away and then you'll be showing us what happened with your seeds.
Okay. So here's mine. It's interesting. You can see that it's actually a little bit of a slant because I planted 2 different types. Half is broccoli and half is the spicy green mix. And they're growing at different rates.
And your upper level also had all kinds of things on it.
This tray that I had used had some planting pellets in it, and I felt like it was too heavy, so I took those out.
Yeah.
So here, let's take a look.
Wow.
Very interesting. So there are 2 different sets of seeds, and they're growing at different rates. In comparison to Maya's from the soil, hers has much better growth than mine. Feels like it's a little bit dry, actually, and that might be why.
So, oh yeah, yours might have soaked up more water.
So I'm gonna make sure that this stays a little bit moister.
Maybe bottom water.
And then we're gonna put these under the lights and come back with some regular updates.
Okay guys, this is where we hit the pause button and review a couple of things. So as you can see, Dr. Riss's microgreens may have been stunted in terms of growth. We believe that it was because of a few things that were in place, and we decided to share this information with you so that you can learn from it as well. Number one, we realized that the jute mat needed to be bottom watered every day. We bottom watered the soil microgreens, so we should have done the same thing with the jute mat. Apparently the jute mat dried up pretty fast, and so the seeds were not receiving adequate moisture. Number two is that the lid that was on top of Dr. Riss's microgreens had added weight that should not have been there. And so we learned that perhaps the microgreens were not allowed to grow as well. Number three, to do an accurate experiment, we should have used the same seeds for the soil and for the jute mat. That's something that we can think about next time. And then Dr. Riss went ahead and replanted his seeds, and you'll see that he had a better turnout. So make sure you watch the rest of the video. Also, you'll see that in the updated videos, he's wearing his blue plant power shirt. And you'll see that the microgreens did much better.
Okay, guys, in this segment, I'm going to show you my microgreens. They have been growing in the dark for about 4 days now. And it's time to bring them out and expose them to the light. And mine are being grown in water on jute mats. So we have them right here. And this, I had this covering on it. And I was growing two different types of microgreens. This side over here is the spicy mixed microgreens. It's, I think, four or five different kinds. And then on this side is the broccoli. We've got reasonably good growth, but it's they're different heights, I think because there's some stuff that's faster growing on this side. And then also in comparison to Maya's, the height of the broccoli microgreens does not seem to be as high. But there is a nice uniform growth. And now at this point, I think the idea will be just to keep the jute mat moist enough to water the microgreens and expose them to light so that they turn green and grow. We're at 4 days, and I think you can harvest anywhere from 8 to 15 days, depending on who you talk to and read about. All right, so now I'm gonna go turn around and put them behind me and put them on the lights. Welcome back, guys. It's day 7, and today we are going to show you our progress on our microgreens, both in soil and in water, and show you a little bit about how we've been maintaining them on a daily basis. So Maya will start with her half of the experiment.
Okay, so day 7, it's been a lot of fun, by the way, watching these grow. The first 3 days, I think, they were in the dark. 4 days, they were in the dark. So here we go. Look how beautiful the greens are. I think they are now like 2 inches, maybe taller.
Mm-hmm, for sure. It's a nice, lush green carpet of microgreens.
Oh, I wish you could see them. Like, it's been wonderful.
And it's kind of fun to kind of do that to them. And then you get to, when you do that, you knock off these the seed husks. Like, for example, there's a seed husk there. So that's one way just to knock some of the seed husks off. But you can eat those, but you can also knock them off.
So when we came out, and I've been trying to photograph or video, but when we came out of day 4, I think darkness, they had already sprouted and they were yellow.
Yep. And probably within about 24 hours of being under the lights behind us, which we'll show you in more detail, they turned green.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we're going to be doing these for about 10 days, you think?
Yeah. I mean, yours are growing faster than mine, which we'll show people, but
yeah.
You can start harvesting. You could probably harvest now if you wanted, but I would give it, let's just see.
Let's just see what happens.
I would give it another, at least 2 or 3 days.
Yeah, because I think the instructions say like 10 days or something like that.
So every day we've also been bottom watering. So I'll show you, I'm just gonna lift this up. And so underneath I would put in about 3 or 4 ounces of water and then I would put this back down in there and let that soak up through the slats in the upper piece and into the soil. So that's how they've been being watered every single day, plus that little misting that I showed you.
So I like that, because by misting, you're covering the top, and by doing the bottom watering, you're covering the soil, and it's an even watering.
All conditions are different depending on how hot it is and how much air circulation, so you'll kind of have to figure out how much water to use. We've been putting in about 3 or 4 ounces, and that seems to be keeping the soil nice and moist and keeping these things growing very well.
Okay, so that's what's been going on with me, and
so,
now
pay good attention to how nice hers look, because now you get to see my experiment, which we're doing on the jute mats in water. This side here is the broccoli sprouts, which are very similar to hers. I think it's a different seed, so it's a little bit of a different look. And this side is the spicy green mix, and so you can see the difference in the look of the microgreens. One thing that I noticed right away when we took them out is that mine were not as mature as hers. And then the jute mat in the bottom was not as moist as her dirt. So I think keeping the jute mat a little bit on the moister side might be more helpful, because my growth isn't as thick or as tall as hers is. And I did have some more immature seeds seedlings, which were still yellow for several more days. And in fact, you can see on this side here, we still do have some that are still maturing. So not everything has turned green.
Do we think it's because there was additional weight?
My lid had some stuff on it, which might have made it too heavy. But who knows, it might just be the different growth medium or the different amount of moisture available for the roots. So then what I've been doing every day So it's been under the growth lights. For the growth lights, we run them from 7 a.m. till midnight. So they're getting 17 hours of light a day. And then every day I've been watering this too. And this is very interesting, what I've been doing here, lifting the mat up and then pouring the water underneath so that it soaks up on the underside of the mat. And I've been doing it on both sides.
Yep.
So I've been working a little harder to keep these moist the last couple of days, because I do think that one of my problems early on was not having enough water for the microgreens. Mm-hmm. But that's where we are so far.
Yeah.
I think hers are going to come to maturation much faster than mine. And you can see the different, this is interesting because I think these are four different types of seeds. And so you can see it's like a mini forest here, a whole bunch of different stuff growing. Stick with us right here. And in just a second, I'm going to show you our growth lights and how we have these things set up. On the jute mats, you can actually lift them up and look at the latticework of roots that are forming underneath. And this is just after 1 week. It's pretty incredible. And I have a couple of different LED grow lights, which I bought specifically for growing plants. So we're trying different ones out. I've got this single piece that I'm trying to get 20 inches of coverage. But you can actually, interesting to see how the plants are kind of growing in this way at a little bit of an angle because the light is coming from up there. And I've got the grow light here about a foot above the microgreens. And then for Mayas that are planted in soil, we have a small LED grow light up here, which I've been using also for my hydroponics garden. At about this distance, it's about 18 inches to 2 feet above. It apparently covers about a 2 square foot area for lighting. Both seem to be working pretty well. Hi everyone, today I'm going to give you a quick update on the microgreens. It is day 7 and I'm here showing you my microgreens, which I've got growing on a jute mat. On this side is the spicy microgreen mix, and on this side is the broccoli. And you can see that it's looking quite good. See, on day 4 is when we took them out of the dark and put them under the light, and very quickly within 1 day they turned green from yellow. And here we are, day 7, and microgreens are really thickening up and growing, and I think are getting very close to time for harvest. What I've been doing on a daily basis is I've been watering the jute mat by literally picking it up and putting some water underneath. So I've been keeping the mats moist so that they don't dry out, but not overly wet. So I've been watering them in the morning, and then I've been spraying the microgreens twice a day, once in the morning and once at night. I think that's especially important with the way that I've been doing things, because I keep them under the grow lights, which you can see behind me. And those grow lights give 17 hours of light a day, but also some heat, which would dry out the growing medium if we didn't keep it watered on a regular basis. So I'm really pleased. So far, so good. And probably the next time we update you, we'll be doing some harvesting. Take care.
Okay guys, if you like this video, please hit the like button and make sure to subscribe, because next time we harvest our microgreens. Thanks for watching.
Don't forget to subscribe.
Hit that notification button.